Everyone, good afternoon and welcome to our Joy-Nostalg Culture Day. And for this exciting afternoon, we shall begin with our mind session. Okay? So the mind session seeks to stimulate our minds through one-hour sessions that focus on specific topics revolving around our Christhood values. It seeks to foster an interactive learning environment through subject matter experts who can share their knowledge and expertise to our employees. Through these sessions, employees can obtain valuable lessons and insights that can allow further growth and enhancement in each professional and personal character. Before we proceed with the talk of our special guest speaker for today, let's first look back at last month's mind session highlights. For a recap of last month's mind session and to know more about the mind session, you may please call on our organization development group head, Ms. Joy Francisco. Good afternoon, Ms. Joy.
Hello, good afternoon, Jello. Thank you. And good afternoon, Joy-Nostalg. The mind session last month was facilitated by Dr. Harriet Hormiliosa with the topic, Your Attitude is Your Altitude. The first part of her talk focused on the value of Christhood, which is the attitude of Christ on being the Anointed One. According to Ms. Harriet, imbibing Christhood could be as simple as picking just one value of Christ and not everything for the day, because what matters is constantly practicing and living an attitude of Christ daily until it becomes second nature. To live out Christhood means being genuine in all your choices, fixating your energy and time into what is authentic, into what truly matters in life. To be Christ-like in spirit and being a steward is living out whatever you have as best as you could, wherever you may be. On the other hand, the psychological meaning of attitude is everything simply means that attitude you choose to emanate in the life that you choose for yourself. One skill does not always guarantee that he is set out to live a good life. Rather, it is someone who has the right attitude that will soar higher. In her own words, a positive attitude will bring you up higher in life. It makes life lighter, helping you reach higher and soar even higher. The power of attitude, especially the right attitude, gives you the ability to create your own destiny. So today, you know, J&G wishes to focus on our Christhood value of unity. Our choice to be ubiquitously one in soul, mind, and body, together as family, for others as community, aligned in diversity unanimously. This is the reason why, despite our differences, we continue to work together and reach our dreams. It encompasses challenges because we know that together we are stronger and we are more capable in delivering better results. Sa loob ng sariling pamilya natin, sa loob ng Joy-Nostalg community, sa ibang komunidad, unity helps us realize that we are not alone. It is my pleasure introducing our speaker for today, you know. Kilala po natin siya, no, because siya po ay nag-facilitate na ng ating leadership formation program, no. So dun po sa mga naka-attend, kilalang-kilala natin ang ating speaker. Siya po ay si Antonette Palma-Angeles, or Dr. Tonette, no, is a professor at the Ateneo de Manila University, where she teaches ethics and leadership. She does leadership and business ethics consulting for Philippine companies and is a regular visiting lecturer at Kyoto University's Asian Business Leadership Program. She was formerly Ateneo's Academic Vice President and Vice President for the Professional Schools. She received her PhD from the Katholieke Universiteit Leuven in Belgium. No? So before we start with her talk, I'd like to encourage everyone, no, to if you have questions later for the talk, please put the chat box, no, and we will try to respond to your questions. So para po mas maging interactive yung session natin later in our question and answer. So again, without further ado, let's all welcome back Dr. Tonette Palma-Angeles.
Hi, Doc. I think you're muted. Sorry. There we go.
Thank you, everyone. And thank you for that applause, because it's very difficult to talk online and people, you don't hear people's reactions. So I'm very glad, of course, to be back. JNG is like family to me. And I'm beginning to say that I know this is a very ungodly hour, and I promise to keep this short and hopefully lively, so that you'll have more time to ask me your questions. So I'm very happy to be here to talk about unity, because I think unity is a very timely topic for this time in our lives. We wouldn't have imagined, about 6-7 months ago, that we will be in this situation and we will need to unite and to be very, very responsive to the needs of each other. So, maganda yung topic ko. Sana meron akong mga maibahagi na palaisipan. At hindi lang palaisipan, sana yung mga ibabahagi ko medyo controversial para magkaroon kayo ng pagkakataon na mag-share. Mahirap talaga yung Zoom discussions dahil hindi ko kayo naririnig, hindi ko kayo nakikita. Kaya aantayin ko na lang ano yung sasabihin ninyo sa chatbot. So thank you everyone for being here. I have some slides, and of course I'll speak over the slides. But if you have any questions, put them in the chat box and then we'll go through them later on after I'm done. Okay. Kasi medyo mahirapan akong tumigil in the middle of the presentation kasi I lose my train of thought. So I will answer your questions. And if I miss any question, perhaps Jello and Joy can help me go back through the questions. Okay. So let's start. When Joy asked me what the title of this short talk will be, I said unity more than ever. Pero isip ko, meron akong magandang naalalang topic or title. So ito yung title na hindi ko alam kung matanda na yung iba sa inyo, kung naalala ninyo ang Voltes 5. Okay. So yung mga ngumingiti na alala, siguro si Ana naalala niya, ngumingiti si Ana eh. So let's bolt in, 'di ba? Ganun yung Voltes 5, yung robots na paborito ng mga anak ko. So yung mga 40s diyan at 30s diyan, alam niyo ito. Si Jello siguro hindi niya alam 'to. Okay. So I think the theme for this afternoon is let's bolt in, and how will we bolt in? I'll just follow a very simple outline, and the outline is, what is it? What is unity? And second, why should we work towards unity? And third, the most important is, how can we build unity? So let me start with this picture that I saw on the web. And Bisaya ako, yung mga hindi nakakaalam. So isa sa mga paborito ko ito. Yung dalawang bagay dito, paboritong-paborito ng Bisaya. So, yung danggit at saka, of course, yung mangga. No? Cebuanas are noted for mangoes and danggit. I wanted to show you this picture to highlight the fact that when you talk about unity, unity is not only in terms of relational unity. Unity is found in many areas of our lives. And one area which is very crucial, where unity is very, very important, is in food combinations, no? So, kunyari, danggit, fried egg, sinangag at kape, kung pwede magtaas lang yung kamay, yung ayaw dyan. Yung ayaw. May nakikita ka, Jello, na ayaw?
Hmm. Parang wala naman, Doc.
Okay siya na combination, di ba? It's an okay combination. And then I have another combination here, di ba? So yes, for many of us, that's an okay combination. Then I have another combination here. Sinong may gusto dyan? Napakitaas lang yung kamay ng may gusto dyan. So fried eggs and inihaw na bangus with iced tea. Is that weird for you? Is that weird? So my question there is, why is that weird? For some people, it's weird. Kasi sabi nila, inihaw na bangus is usually eaten for lunch. And iced tea is usually not drunk in the morning because kailangan ng tiyan ng mainit sa umaga. No? And in fact, sa Tagalog, may magandang ginagamit silang salita. Ang gamit nilang salita, pares. Okay? Merong mga bagay na pares at may mga bagay na hindi talaga pares. So, it's called pares bagay. So, unity is found in food combinations. For instance, it will be very, very strange for you to eat sinigang with french fries. Okay, that will be the weirdest thing of all, diba? Or it will be very, very weird for us to eat, for instance, mashed potatoes with nilaga. No? Or baka mayroong kumakain yan. Hindi ko lang alam. Baka may mga weird. So parang hindi bagay yon. So unity is not only in relations but also in food combinations. Ito, hindi ko kilala itong artistang to, ha? So sorry kung mayroong may idol. Grinab ko lang to sa internet. Kung titingnan ninyo, meron bang, how many of you feel uncomfortable with this picture? Can you just raise your hand? So I can see. Uncomfortable, marami ba? Marami ba kang nakikita? Can somebody unmute himself or herself and tell me why is this picture not right?
I'll answer, Doc.
Yes.
I think it's very out of touch because she's clearly all made up and she has a designer handbag and yet she is walking by what appears to be a slum area.
Yeah. So exactly, you know, parang she's too dressed up for the area. Tapos yung pang bag, napaka mukhang social nung bag. Tapos slum area yung nilalakalan. Siguro Rimowa pa yung maleta na yan. It will probably cost how much? How much is a Rimowa? 100,000? Okay. So parang out of sync siya. No? So that unity is also found actually in fashion. Okay. And I'll tell you, I like fashion. I've read a lot about fashion because I like fashion. And there are things that actually don't go together. Fashion sense, no? So, kanina, yung sumagot, sabi niya, hindi yata angkop sa lugar at okasyon yung damit ng babae. Pero yung isa din sa fashion, dapat bagay din sa atin. Sabi nila, pag medyo malaki tayo, huwag magsumuot ng horizontal, no, stripes. No? Dapat vertical stripes ang isuot. Tapos huwag pagsabayin. Sabi nila, ang polka dots at no, stripes, nagka-clash daw na yung mata daw ng taong tumitingin maduduling. So merong mga bagay at hindi bagay sa fashion. So merong expression ginagamit sa English, pag yung babae magaling magbihis, ang sabi natin sa English, this woman is so put together. In other words, the thing she puts on her body is so put together. But I put there also, no, the word appropriate, which really is very much in keeping with the first bullet point. That good fashion sense is not only about what is bagay to me and that I look put together, but it is also appropriate for the place and for the moment. That's what dressing up fashionably is about. So I'd like to... Baka may mga bahay na ganitong ginawa ang J&G. Baka magalit sa akin. Gusto kong tingnan ninyo itong bahay na ito. Tingnan nyo lang mabuti, ha, kasi may isa pa akong bahay na ipapakita. Okay. So please note this house, diba? Big windows, all closed windows. Okay. And then look at this house. Can somebody please unmute herself or herself to tell me just very quickly what your observation is? Anyone?
I think the second house is simpler in a way, right? I mean, the first house was very, very, it looked a bit more lavish, I think.
Okay.
This is more, itong pangalawa is more like connected with nature.
Okay. So connected more, why do you say more connected with nature, Jello?
Mas fresco siya eh. And the porch area, it's al fresco, it's more open, di ba? Yun lang po.
Okay. Anyone else would like to say anything?
Me, Dr. Tonette.
Hi.
Hi. Both houses look great. Mm-hmm. Diba? They just have a different aesthetic.
Okay.
So, I guess one is more suited to the more, I guess, more developed part because you didn't see a lot of greenery there. But this mm-hmm. one, it seems to be more bagay to the nature around because it's surrounded by the trees and things like that. So, they're both beautiful. They're just in different surroundings.
Okay. So these are both beautiful houses actually in themselves, but as Chico and Jello says, perhaps the second house is more suited for its surroundings. So I'd like to go back to that first slide. This actually, this house has become very fashionable in the Philippines. No? In my neighborhood, the new houses look like this. But then I saw a documentary featuring a Singaporean architect. And he said that he doesn't understand why houses in tropical countries are built with windows like this, which cannot open, when in fact, these windows, he said, absorb heat. So yung mga nagpaplano sa inyong magpagawa ng bahay, isipin nyo ito. Kasi sabi niya, yung mga bintanang to, hindi nabubuksan. At yung mga bintanang to, ang lakas-lakas nila bilang conductors ng init. Tapos tingnan niyo yung awning ng bintanang to. Di ba may mga awning sa pinto at sa mga bintana? Yung awning daw na yan, ang mangyayari sa awning na yan, dahil hindi siya nakaslant, lahat ng ulan, makikita ninyo in about 6 months, madumi na yung pintura ng awning na yan. Dahil hindi naman talaga siya nakaslant. No? Masyado siyang flattened. Whereas this second house is really a stylized nipahat. It's a stylized nipahat which has the main features of a nipahat. Na yung bubong niya, nag-overhang dahil malakas ang ulan sa Pilipinas. So yung buong bahay, hindi mababasa, walang awning na mababasa. Tapos naka-elevate siya dahil bumabaha sa Pilipinas. So, yung tubig, hindi ka agad papasok sa bahay. At dahil mainit, meron siyang nakapaligid, nakabalot na parang veranda. Tapos hindi siguro masyadong mapapansin, pero ang nipahat ay marami ding bintana. Pero nabubuksan yung bintana. So, in fact, you can actually build two beautiful houses, as Chico said. But when is a house beautiful? A house is not beautiful in itself. Okay? A house is always beautiful, only no, it's not so much about what I want, what's my lifestyle. No? It's also no, not quite the same as sometimes what I want and what my lifestyle is clashes with what my architects want and what I find in Pinterest no, or what I find in magazines. And sometimes those houses are beautiful in themselves, but those houses do not suit my budget, obviously. But then, more important, I think, is that many houses that we build in this country are not really suited to our weather. It's not mindful of the fact that so that when you build a house, it's also ostentatious, too beautiful, in a neighborhood that's really very, very low middle class. So, hindi siya bagay. So, again, lumabas na naman yung salita na ginagamit. No? Bagay. Appropriate. So, maaring maganda siya sa papel, sa design, Pero para maging maganda yung bahay, dapat maging bagay siya at maging akma siya sa paligid niya at sa mga pangangailangan ng taong nakatira doon. So, in fashion, it's about being put together. In food, it's about pares, kailangan bagay. And in houses, it's also about appropriateness, it's also about bagay. So why did I start with that? I started with that because, in fact, unity is not only used to describe human relations, but it is also used to describe, you know, things in fashion and our houses and even our food. So, Jella, may I just ask you to play this YouTube slide
sure,
now?
Ma'am.
YouTube video. Up.
Ma'am, okay. Kindly share your PowerPoint.
Okay.
Thank you.
To travel in groups.
Thank you, Jello.
Sure, ma'am.
Thank you. I like this slide because it illustrates very, very well what unity can do. No? Whereas if you are not acting as one or two of you could die. But acting as one, you can actually save the entire group. No? So, unity, therefore, is not only about yung gusto ko lang. No? It's not only about yung gusto ko. Kasi kung yung gusto ko lang ang masusunod, maaaring mapapahamak ang grupo. I just like to call your attention that young people are like this. No? If those of you who have teenagers, children in college, and if you still remember when you were young, it's about declaring freedom from your parents. It's about the I want syndrome. So, for instance, my students in the Ateneo rebel against the dress codes. Gusto nilang magbihis ng kahit anong gusto nila. Kaya yung iba sa kanila, pakita puso, pakita likod, pakita lahat, kumare. Okay? So that it's about what they want. No? Also, young people rebel against house rules. But if you notice, no? And if you still remember, habang tumatanda ka, at marami sa atin medyo tumatanda na, okay? We are all about conformity. Nakakapagtaka, why is it that the older people become, the more people conform? Whereas young people do not want to conform, older people conform. It's no longer about hindi yung gusto ko. And I think the reason for that is because for the adult among us, we realize that if we insist on what we want, we're going to destroy the lives of other people. And therefore, unity is asking yourself the first question. Una, if you want to talk about unity, you have to ask, what is the context? In other words, when I make a decision or when I am in a situation and I'm trying to figure out what I should do, the first question to ask is, what's the context? Pag nagpapagawa ako ng bahay, anong klaseng neighborhood? Ano yung kailangan ko? Ano yung weather? At yung pangalawa, okay, tinatanong natin, ngayon alam ko na ano yung konteksto. Ang pangalawang tanong, if you want to be in harmony with other people, ano yung nababagay gawin? So two very important points. What's the context? At ano yung bagay? Pag alam ko na yung konteksto, ano yung bagay? Okay? So then, let's try to wrap up this definition part of unity. Unity, and you know this very well, is about oneness. But it's not only about oneness. It's also about harmony. So tanong dyan, nararamdaman niyo ba sa J&G to na meron kayong oneness at meron kayong harmony? No? Kung hindi man sa kumpanya, at least doon sa mga divisions natin sa J&G. Okay? So that unity is really relational togetherness. It's about being together and working together and having harmonious relations. Or it's about working as one. Okay? In contrast, no? There are companies, and they will not survive because they are like this. They're about silos. Okay? In other words, silos means one group, no, exists and mindful. Walang pakialam kung anong nangyayari sa kabila. So, kanya-kanya. So, silos in Tagalog is kanya-kanya. And so, they're very divided. Guys, if you've been watching the news, you may have realized and you may have read that Jollibee has lost billions of pesos. I want you to, for a moment, just reflect on that. This was the most high-flying company in the Philippines. And today, it has lost billions of pesos. And many Jollibee branches in the hundreds have closed already, and many of them are company owned. Now more than ever, Jollibee needs to act as one. Okay? Because if Jollibee does not act as one, Jollibee's problem is Jollibee will go down. So from being number one, if Jollibee does not have unity, Jollibee will certainly be in deep trouble if they do not address adversity as a team. Now they really have to address adversity as a team. Okay? So, yung sunod kong tanong, why unity? Obviously, makikita ninyo that the more profitable companies are those who are really very unified. You know, J&G before the pandemic was doing very well and we are profitable. But the thing is, profitability, you know, runs in cycles because the competition will catch on. Or sometimes we get complacent. And so we cannot talk about unity only at the beginning when we are being profitable. Unity has to persist. So we want to be profitable, then we have to be very unified. For instance, may mga taong gumagawa ng tinatawag nilang operations research, di ba? Ano yung ginagawa nila? Ginagawa talaga nila, binabasa nila yung kumpanya para yung operations ng kumpanya, ang tawag nila sa Ingles, seamless. No? Seamless dahil yung mga taong gumagawa, alam nila kung ano yung obligasyon nila at kailan nila ipapasa sa sunod na departamento. So it's a seamless operation. There is great teamwork. And that provides profitability. But profitability can only persist if unity also persists. So why do we need unity? Because we want to be profitable. And of course, we want to be efficient. Here I cite a company which took the number one position in the late 60s and 70s and which is still number one in the world today. The company is Toyota. Okay? And Toyota, the assembly of Toyota cars is one of the most efficient assembly lines. And in fact, it's called the Toyota way. So please Google it if you want it. So there is a great community teamwork in Toyota. That's why the cars in Toyota, they overtook the American cars first and then they overtook the German cars. So Toyota, in fact, is number one because of great teamwork. And that teamwork is called the Toyota way. You know? And it is always a case study in operations research. So that this is efficiency. Why unity? It will create efficiency. And then, of course, as I was saying about Jollibee, unity is also about survival of the company. we are trying to be as unified as we can if we want to keep the company afloat. Okay. And then, because we're Pinoys, unity is also very important because Pinoys want to be happy in the workplace. We want harmony in the workplace. So we want unity kasi ayaw natin na rant ng rant at reklamo ng reklamo sa bawat isa, sa departmentong to, sa departmentong yan. Dahil kung hindi tayo, wala tayong unity, magre-reklamo tayo palagi. And we will be unhappy. We will really be unhappy in our companies. And then, why unity? Because in the final analysis, this is what being a Christian is. We work with each other because we want to be kind and compassionate to each other. Unity is about, in the highest scheme of things, it's about kindness and compassion. Okay? And in business, we think of our bigger community, and that bigger community is we are a unity because we want to serve the clients and the nation better. The classic example, of course, today of a department that has no unity is the Department of Health. It's been in the spotlight for a long time, and it is a classic example of a department that has no unity. And even the government has been faulted that one department speaks one language and then the other department speaks another language. So they're not able to serve us better. So these are the reasons why we speak of the need for unity. Okay? So why unity? Because we are an organic system. Ano ba yung organic? Ibig sabihin ng organic, alam ko maraming sinasabi dyan, organic potatoes, organic whatever. Pero hindi yan yung ibig sabihin ng organic dito. Ang ibig kong sabihin ng organic dito, organic means isang buhay at gumagalaw at nagbabagong sistema. Ang JNG, successful ngayon, pero ang JNG is an organic organization. So kailangan siyang palaguin. Kailangan siyang, it has to, as they say in English, JNG has to roll with the punches. COVID-19 is one of those hard-hitting punches. So as an organic system, we have to be ready to roll with the punches. We have to grow. And the only way we can do that is if we are a team. So if it is an organic system, when one part is sick, we all get affected. Kaya gusto ko lang magbigay ng halimbawa dito na yung transference of disease. Kunyari, kami, hindi kami lumalabas sa bahay namin. Or kayo, hindi kayo lumalabas sa bahay namin. Tapos meron kayong isang membro ng pamilya na napaka-careless, nalalabas, na nagpa-party. At anong mangyayari? Kahit yung mga nasa loob ng bahay, ayos na ayos yung health nila, pagpasok nun ng asymptomatic na bata, mahahawa tayo lahat. No? So, if one of us is ill, the others will get ill. So we cannot then say that I will just take care of my needs because unity is about the different members of a whole working together because those different members of that whole will all get affected. If one gets sick, the others will also get sick. So meron lang akong diagram dito ng ibig sabihin ng unity. So yung family's welfare, kunyari nakikita ko na yung iba sa inyo, kilala ko kayo, meron kayong mga pamilya, at gusto niyong maghanap buhay, di ba? Yung second circle, gusto niyong maghanap buhay. Pero yung hanap buhay niyo, nakasalalay sa JNG, na mag-survive ang JNG. Maswerte tayo yung mga kumpanya natin, buhay. Buhay ang Ateneo, buhay ang JNG, nakakapagtrabaho pa rin tayo. Yung anak ko, may close friend. Unfortunately, yung close friend niya, parehong nagtatrabaho sa Cebu Pacific. Yung baliktad sila, yung babae, piloto, pilota, yung lalaki, steward. Yung Cebu Pacific nagli-lay off. Kaya yung babae, she's able to maneuver a plane, drive a plane, only for 2 days in 1 month. So, kumbaga, gusto nating alagaan yung pamilya natin, pero yung pag-aalaga natin sa pamilya, kailangan kumita tayo, pero yung kita natin depends on the business survival. But the business survival is very much dependent on the health of its employees. That's why the employees have to take care of themselves. But for the employees to take care of themselves, kailangan they have to have safe transport. Yung public transport system, dapat importante na maayos. At yung health services sa Pilipinas, dapat importante maayos kasi kung mahina yung public health natin, wala tayong malalapitan kung nagkasakit tayo. At kailangan natin yung efficient government. The countries that have successfully managed the pandemic, as you all know, have very efficient governments. So lahat itong circles na ito, they're all interrelated. So ibig sabihin, there has to be, I love the English word. The English word is concerted effort. No? There has to be concerted effort. Each part contributing to making sure that the whole functions. Okay. So the other question, the last question now I'd like to address is, how does one build a community? And I'd like to divide this last portion to two parts. So how will the company itself build, you know, unity? And how will individual employees in J&G build community? Okay. First of all, I think J&G will really have to hire the right people. Not just the competent ones, but hires who should be like-minded, who think like the J&G vision. Hires who will share the values, you know? And therefore, because they share the values, these people, therefore, you know, will create a bond, will be part of the bond. They will not stick out, okay, in the company. The second is the company will have to constantly instill belief, you know, through company-wide and department-wide programs. And I think we're already doing this. No, we're doing this a lot. So I will not dwell on that. Instill a strong belief in the company and in unity through programs. For instance, this Culture Day is one of them. Okay. The third, which this Culture Day again is about rituals. Okay. We have to create rituals. So for instance, when you are already married, your parents most likely will insist that you still go home to the family, to the ancestral home every Sunday. When you're young, you fight against that because you'd rather spend it somewhere else. But truthfully, the bondedness of a family depends on your willingness to participate on those rituals. So the company will have to create rituals and we have to participate on those rituals. Without those rituals, we will not have a sense of team. Guys, I've been with the Ateneo since I was first year college. And there are two rituals in the Ateneo, which are very, very important. One is the Mass of the Holy Spirit, which starts at the beginning of the school year. And then there is the basketball game. Okay, we build our strong sense of loyalty through that basketball game. And then the third, of course, is we participate actually in the July 31 team building where all the Jesuits come out and all their lay partners come out. These rituals define for me, you know, what it means for me to belong to an Ateneo community. Rituals are very important. And then the company has to constantly communicate the vision and mission of the organization. And again, I don't want to dwell on that because I think we know how important that is. Okay. And then here is the last company intervention, which I think is very necessary. The company should already have structures that will make people work together in times of crisis. For instance, there should be a body system. In times of crisis, in times of difficulties, there should be a body system where somebody will help catch you para pag hirap na hirap ka, may sasalo sa'yo. And then there should be a regular kamustahan system or kamustahan sessions. I don't know how often it is. It's not like Culture Day kasi sa Culture Day ang dami-dami natin. Kamustahan sessions can be only with 4 or 5 people para lang lalo at maari siguro hanggang maari merong bata at merong may edad para meron ding mentorship session doon sa kamustahan sessions na yun. Para mas naiintindihan ng bata ang mas may edad at mas naiintindihan ng may edad Nostalg yung mas bata. So, kailangang merong kamustahan session para pag may problema sa kumpanya, meron tayong matatakbuhan. Hindi natin itatakbo sa mga taong walang magawa kung hindi sugsugan lang yung chismis. So, kailangan yung structures which will allow us to work together in times of adversity. And then let's go to this other thing which is very important. When you are already talking about individuals, what can individuals do? Okay. Individuals must know what's going on in the different J&G departments. In other words, makiusyoso naman. Huwag yung puro yung departmento ko lang ang alam ko. In another leadership training session, we will talk about this as systems thinking. Think of what is going on, not only in terms of what people are doing, but really, how does the other department function? Paano ba nagpa-function yung mga departmento sa JNG na kumukuha ng mga permits sa gobyerno? Paano ba nagpa-function yung departmento sa JNG na nasa foundation na? Na yung tinutulungan na nila yung mga low-income families para mabayaran nila yung kanilang amortization? Paano ba nagpa-function yung mga nasa accounting auditing teams? Paano ba nagpa-function yung mga nasa finance team? So, how do we build unity as an individuals? Makiusyoso naman. Okay? Alamin ko anong nangyayari sa ibang departamento. And, no, we always think of the good of others. At dito ko i-highlight, the good of others you can't see. You don't personally know. We just do not think about our interests, our friends, and our departments. Kasi itong mga ito, kaibigan at departmento, kilala ka ito. Kaya meron ako mga halimbawa dito. I have some examples which I just want to go through quickly because I think these are examples which highlight the point I'm trying to make. For instance, when I don't report for work, dahil for the flimsiest of reasons, tinatamad lang ako, masama pakiramdam ko, pero hindi naman talaga masamang masama, ang tatanungin natin palagi, anong epekto niyan sa ibang tao? Kasi maaring pag maling Tagalog ko dyan, hindi tatamian, kundi tatamaan. Okay. So that, kasi pag hindi tayo pumasok sa trabaho, ang mangyayari kasi, yung ibang tao ang sasalo para sa atin. So kayo kawawa yung taong sasalo, di ba? Or for instance, kunyari, pagtatama rin akong pumasok sa klase, tapos meron akong mga ibang estudyante, galing pa ng Pasig, galing pa ng Makati, tapos tinamad akong hindi papasok. Kawawa naman yung mga estudyante, pinaghanda ng mga nanay nila ng pagkain, nag-commute, hirap na hirap. Pagdating sa eskwelahan, wala doon yung teacher. So, building unity is about being empathic about other people's needs, not only about people I see. And then I want you to pay attention to this second example because this is a true story of a university. There was a very stubborn labor union in a university in Leyte. And they did not believe that the priests who run the university really could not give in anymore to their demands. Anong nangyari? Maliit yung town pinaroroonan nila. Nagsara yung university. At ano yung masakit dito? Ang masakit dito, hindi lang naman yung labor union ang nawala ng trabaho. Lahat ng tao, no? Nawala ng trabaho sa university at yung university, yun yung main source of income ng bayan na ito, this town in Leyte. And this is a true story. And para sa akin, masakit ito dahil yung labor union, nag-negotiate lang sila dahil ito yung gusto nila. Hindi nila nakikita yung tinatawag nila sa Ingles na abstract stakeholders. Yung mga tatamaang tao na hindi sa paligid ko, kung hindi mas malayo sa akin, hindi ko nakikita. Ang nakikita ko lang, ano yung gusto ko. So if you want to build unity as an individual, I think you have to be very mindful of the people who you do not see because they're not close to you. They're not family, they're not relatives. And then the other one is, alam nyo siguro yung NHK, ito yung parang CNN ng Japan. At alam nyo siguro na yung Prime Minister ng Japan nag-resign na. At nag-resign siya dahil may sakit siya. So ito yung sinabi ng NHK tungkol sa pag-resign niya. Pakibasa na lang. So, in fact, nung nangyari to, maraming pumalakpak kay Abe kasi sabi nila, si Abe actually could still stay in power kasi yung party niya is the ruling party. Eh. So, he can still stay in power. Pero si Abe, for the sake of, again, here, a very important word, for the sake of the common good, okay, decided to resign so that somebody who is better, in better health and who could make better decisions than him can make the decisions for his country. So I wanted to give these three examples to show you that building unity, very important. And I think the challenge is how do we institutionalize this in JNG? Everyone should be encouraged to see beyond the tip of their noses. Everyone should be encouraged to see beyond his interests and his friends, his family, or his department. Because whatever we do in an organization, there'll be a greater number of individuals we don't see who will be affected. So if we really want to build unity in JNG, we have to learn to appreciate the common good. Okay. So let me then summarize. I come to the end of my short presentation. Okay. Unity simply means working as one, and perhaps this is cliche-ish, alam na natin to, pero yung challenge ay hindi naman yung definition eh. Ang challenge, paano? At dito mahirap. How? It's not only about hindi lang ang gusto ko. Kasi mahirap ito sa Filipino because the Filipino is very family-oriented, very clannish. Okay? And so how do we make ourselves and the company and the employees in the company work together in such a way na hindi lang yung gusto ko at hindi lang yung gusto ng department ang aking isalang-alang pag nagde-decision ako? So that we have to think of the good of the many, or what is known as the common good. Okay? At yung aking suggestion, makiramdam, makiramay, makisama. Okay? Palaging makiramdam. Importante yung pakiramdam, makiramdam sa iba. Makiramay at makisama sa iba. Okay? So that unity will give us not only short-term success, because sometimes short-term success is a fluke. Okay? Unity will give us long-term success. And in the end, it will teach us kindness. Okay? Unity should always spring from kindness. So I hope in JNG we will have long-term success and we will be kind to each other. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you and good afternoon. You can ask me your questions now.
Thank you so much, Dr. Tonette, for that very inspiring talk. About our Christchurch value for the month, unity. Let's now look at some of the questions that were submitted by our employees no, during our talk. So we will check the chat box if meron. And while people are still busy writing down their questions in the chat box, I invite our panelists here who are online, who are on video, if they have any questions or comments to Dr. Palma-Angeles. Okay, Doc, I have one question. In fact, while you were giving your talk, my teammate and I were commenting on our own. No? And it's really tama kayo. No, unity is so important given this very difficult time. No, you said that unity demands us to move as one and to act as one organization, but how can unity be implemented, especially in a difficult time like this, no, where our priority is to stay safe and to protect our families? No, our current setup situation right now, dahil sa pandemic, has made us independent and even, to an extent, individualistic, right? So how do we move towards a more collective mindset when right now, despite our work, despite what we need to do to provide homes for the homeless, we think of our safety and that of our families. So how can we be more united?
First of all, I cannot, JNG will have, I don't know if you remember my slide.
Yeah.
My slide has this, you have to have measures which build unity during times of adversity. What does that mean? Because I don't think this will be the first adversity that JNG will encounter. Mas marami pa yung magka problema. Heaven forbid, magka earthquake, magka baha. Di ba marami pang adversity dyan? Or, kunyari, hindi lang yan yung adversity na maaari. Kunyari, hindi na kumikita ng malaki. Katulad ngayon. Diba? So, number one, I think there has to be some institutional measures introduced that will allow you to still build teamwork even if you stay in place. Let me give you an example. I have been staying in place since March, you know, because we were not allowed to go to Ateneo since March. So you can imagine how long that has been. But immediately, actually, we were taught to form kamustahan teams in the philosophy department so that hindi to bola, hindi talaga ito bola. I used to go to the philo department every Tuesday, Thursday. But ngayon, meron akong dalawang teams na inuupuan na may mga bata. Yung isa ako lang yung senior, yung isa dalawa kaming senior. At ang ginagawa lang namin, pag nasistress na sila, no, kung dahil sa preparation, nag-uusap kami. Pero tinutulungan din namin sila kasi meron akong certain expertise. Tinutulungan ko rin sila i-navigate yung kanilang ginagawang mga course outline. Nagkikita kami every 2 weeks, no? Online, nag-zoom kami. Kung minsan, pinag-usapan lang namin yung personal nila, pero kadalasan, pinag-usapan namin paano namin paggaganahin yung kanilang pag-prepare ng kanilang course outline. So, I'm answering you two ways. First, the company, I think, will have to put in some measures that will still build teamwork, even if you are staying in place. And those measures could be like our kamustahan measures. So it can be done. But the second one, I think, is individually, I think everyone will really have to be very, very, yung antena mas nakalabas na mas JNG i-prioritize, apart from my family, i-prioritize ang JNG. Kasi, sa totoo lang, kung hindi ninyo ipa-prioritize ang JNG, pag JNG runs out of business, we're all going to be in deep trouble.
Right. Yeah. No, from what you said about what Ateneo did, no, you have these sessions wherein they'll actually reach out to you, no, and ask you how you are.
We are. How you're doing. We form teams.
We have kayo, four kayo, no? Kayo, kayo. And so there seems to be a connection between compassion, care, and concern for people, for one another, and the tendency to be united as one. Am I correct, ma'am? There's a connection between being united, which is brought about by a sense of concern, compassion.
Yeah, but kaya lang yung kasing concern and compassion.
Right.
Hindi naman yan basta nandiyan na lang eh. That's something you have to build up. And I think the challenge for the companies, how do you build that? No?
Right.
People. And so I'm saying on the one hand, that's a very individual thing. I have to teach myself compassion. Mm-hmm. But on the other hand, there are also institutional measures that can be put in place so that people are still able to care for each other, even if they don't physically see each other.
Right, right. Despite the heavy workload, there should always be time to check on each other.
When you have a heavy workload, I think.
Right.
You have to help each other because some of you might be so stressed already.
Right, right.
And you're not able to express it. Mm-hmm. And so when one part of the team has a nervous breakdown, that's going to ruin the team.
Correct. Correct. It backfires, no?
Yeah. So right. That, for instance, if there's five of us and one part of the team is having such a hard time, then perhaps because there's five of us, then we can talk to management because there's five of us and we can say, look, we cannot do this. Our team members are breaking apart. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's the value, no, of little teams and then the JNG becoming a big team. But we have to have several teams in JNG, actually. Small teams and then the company itself.
Right. Right. So definitely there should always be time for people to find their center, to look within, to pause, to breathe, no?
That's one. But the other one, I think the one for me, because I'm such a operations person, is
right.
It because that's very personal. Eh. I have to center, I have to pray, and so on and so forth. But connecting to others is not only about praying. Mm-hmm. Connecting to others is about having the interventions that will allow me to connect. And at this point in time, it's very important that there are structures for connection.
Correct. Yes, ma'am. And a while ago, ma'am, you mentioned that, yes, we have to take care of our families, but we also need to prioritize our work. No, we protect ourselves, we protect our families, but we also have to see the value of our work in JNG. Now, you mentioned a while ago that we need to have routines, rituals, programs in place to build this, lack of a better term, to build this loyalty or to build this common shared acceptance of this goal. No? But how do you think can we create more? How do you think can we make people in the company believe in our common mission and vision more? They say when you share a goal or a vision, diba, this unites people. When they see the importance of providing homes, when they see the importance of sparking joy wherever they go, diba, this unites us to do our best in everything we do for the company. So given this difficult time, what's one tip you can give us to create more sincere buy-in for our employees to embrace our mission in JNG despite this difficult time?
There's no... If I give you a short-term answer, mambubola ako. Ayoko nang bubola. There's no shortcut kasi to building teams. Eh.
Mm.
There's no shortcut to building synergy. So I already gave you my 2 cents worth about at the moment how you can help each other in this difficult time. But in the long term, again, we have to have a program for team building in the long term, meaning after the pandemic, because people will not just buy into a mission vision because we talk about it. You know, I'm a rabid Atenean because I've been in Ateneo since 1973. Yeah.
Okay.
In other words, and Ateneo has done so many things, made me go on retreats, whatever. No? So for us to be rabid JNGers, there will have to be company programs that will make us really see the value of the mission vision. Because the mission vision of JNG is really wonderful. As I keep saying participants in the workshop, I haven't seen a company that's like that. Na talagang, ang ano talaga ng passionate about capacitating a certain segment of society. Mm-hmm. But then we will have to have a certain communication savvy, and we have to have a way of convincing our employees to do that. And leaders, are specially tasked with that.
Right. Okay, thank you, Doctor. Now, I welcome my co-panelists who are now online. No? If they have any more comments, insights, or questions to share with Doctor and the people here. All right. So at this point, I'd like to give the floor now to our organization development group head, Ms. Joy Francisco. Welcome back, Ms. Joy.
Hey, thank you, Jello. And again, thank you, Dr. Net, for your insights on unity. No? Dr. Net mentioned some key points on unity. No? She said that unity is not really about what I want. Unity is about harmony being one. She also mentioned that unity is what makes companies succeed in difficult times for profit, efficiency, and survival. It also demands us to see ourselves as interconnected parts, no? And the company has an important role to play in inspiring unity through its programs and rituals. And I think Dr. Net mentioned about the experience of care and compassion, no? And we become more united if we're able to experience and give that to each other, no? The care and compassion. So with that key points, we'd like again to thank Dr. Tonette, for this afternoon, for we appreciate again your presence, no? And we hope to see you again in our future talks, no? And as a way of saying thank you for the time and effort of imparting your knowledge and expertise to us, no? Please accept this certificate of appreciation, no? Online na po, Doc, no? So allow me to read our certificate of appreciation. This is hereby awarded to Doc Antonette Palma-Angeles, no? As our joyful tribute and appreciation for sharing your presence and experience with us, and for sparkling light, hope, and love in our Joy Nostalgia Culture Day Mind Session. May you always continue to be the light that sparkles and shines ever so bright, creating moments of happiness and memories of hope for others. Spark Joy, moreover, awarded this fourth day of September in the year of our Lord 2020. This is signed by Ms. Mylene Lim, our Chief Executive Officer, Resource Management Unit, and Mr. Jacinto Nang Jr., Group Executive Officer. Join us all, Ju. So once again, Dr. Nell, thank you very much for your wonderful talk this afternoon.
Thank you again, Dr. Tonette, for being with us. Now, your talk is very timely with what we're going through right now. And unfortunately, no, Mr. Nang was not able to be here. But for sure, he would have loved your talk, and he will watch this recorded talk later on today. No? So once again, thank you, Dr. Tonette, and we hope to work with you very soon and to have you back with us. Thank you, ma'am.